At Carter Street Police Station in South London today, PC Tony Geary was feeling glad to be alive. The wound on his arm, the torn shirt, the hole in the sleeve of his uniform jacket, and most telling of all, the smashed radio which saved his life, tell the story of what happened to him this morning. It was his first week alone on the beat. As he was passing Wollaston Close around 7:30, he heard a call from the roof of this block of flats. Seconds later, a crossbow bolt thudded into his radio set, which he was wearing over his left breast. It almost certainly stopped the bolt from piercing his heart and killing him. Moments after that, a second bolt hit him in his right arm.
At this stage, he tried to duck for cover and saw there was a man on the roof of those flats holding on to a crossbow and loading a third bolt into it. He ducked for cover and called for assistance when the man's made off.
Is there any explanation as to why this man should have been shot?
No explanation whatsoever. The officer was just on patrol, doing his lawful duty, had not been involved in any incident just before which can give any excuse for this type of behaviour whatsoever.
Police believe the bolt was fired from a crossbow known as a trident. The sale of crossbows, like the one that nearly killed PC Geary, were banned from sale to anyone under the age of 17 only 2 weeks ago. But anyone over 17 can still buy these old-fashioned but deadly weapons and the heavy-duty plastic bolts that they shoot. As to the man that used the one this morning, police are looking for a young white man in his early 20s with ginger hair and wearing a green combat jacket and blue jeans. And the police also want to talk to the person who made an anonymous 999 telephone call to them from a box outside Labour Party headquarters in the Walworth Road last Tuesday at 9:45 p.m. He told them that a man armed with a crossbow in nearby Browning Street had threatened to kill a policeman. They also urgently need to speak to anyone else who may have seen this man since last Tuesday. Christopher Rainbow in South London.